I'm just gonna use that much. It's a little bit heavy, but it is what it is. There's one coat. Hey Greg, Drew, what's happening y'all? I'm gonna get up to the second coat here. You guys can see how I'm applying it. Not much skill to it. This takes a lot of the work out of it. I'm just gonna be pretty thorough here. Just like normal sandpaper, you're going to spend most of your time on the lower grits. And my lathe is going about 1650 RPM. For those of you who are just getting here. Clean that off. And that is the second coat. A little thinner. And I'm using just light pressure. I'm not pressing hard at all. Very light. And this is only 1,000 grit, and you guys can see that material already coming to life here. I'm excited to see what she's going to look like. I'm tempted to do one more coat, but I'm going to leave it like it is. What's up, Tim? All right, how's y'all's view here? I believe that's where I was. I'm just going to clean it off real quick here. Any excess I want gone. So it's not standing in the way of the next grit. I normally do this on the low grits. I don't even think I'm going to do 2000 grit. I think I'm just going to jump right up into 15. Be able to tell pretty quick if that's a mistake or not. And here's some 15. Ronnie, as soon as I finished turning, I went to 220, then I hit it with 320, and I finished up with 400. That's all I sand typically. Some guys go up to 800 or so. And as usual, we're not doing a whole lot of pressure. I mean, we're going very, very light here. And that's the first coat. that. And I'll hit it one more time. Just 15K. Skip 2K altogether just to see. Now I'm starting to apply a little bit of pressure here. We're going to speed up to about 2,000 RPM. I agree with you there, Laura. It's pretty chill. It's therapeutic for me, that's for sure. Now let's get that off here. And that's two coats of 15K. We'll see if I made a mistake by skipping the 2K and going right to the 15 or not here in just a little bit. You really see that blue starting to pop. Sorry for putting my big hands in the way here. Alright, let's take a look. I don't think y'all can see that from over there, but I mean, honestly, I could stop right now and be happy with that finish. It's already better than micro mesh. Excuse me. All right. Should we keep going up to 50 or just stop right there? Yeah, we'll go up to 50. What the hell? All right. And here's the 50K. It does not take much at all. Good to hear, Len. I know I'm getting y'all's way, I'm sorry. Alright, that's the first coat. We're gonna do two just because. Speed up, we're going about 2400. Start applying a little bit more pressure. I'm gonna do one more coat just because. You guys see how fast it is. It's not very long. Bit of pressure, I mean just a little bit, you guys can already see it starting to jump to life there, even more than what it was. soon as you start to feel a little bit of heat, you can go ahead and let off. And by the time it makes it through the towel here, it's already pretty warm on the blank. Go to a clean spot on the towel here. Kind of remove any and all excess. Wow. I don't know if y'all can see that or not, but wow. Here. And you know what? While I got an extra minute, we'll just go ahead and do the 80K. Excuse me. All right. Yeah, let's go ahead and do some 80K on it. Had a little dirty piece of towel there. But that is first coat here, nothing to it. Yeah, Laura, that last one. It was 50,000 grit. That really made it smooth like glass. Got rid of the small remaining scratches. This 80K, if you do it right and consistently enough, you get rid of all the scratches. You need a jeweler's loop to be able to see any. And once again, I'm just going very, very light on my passes here. Len, you do the exact same thing over wood, yes. Except feel free to use the DNA right before you begin after sanding, you know? Alright, now I'm going to put a little bit of pressure on. You can already see the difference from the last 50K grit we had. Crazy to think you can jump that high between grits, but you sure can. Alright, that's the first pass here. We will go for pass number two. I just start moving a little bit faster, turn the lathe up. We're about 3,000 RPM now. And I'm applying a little bit of pressure, not much. I don't want to actually cause scratches. Go a little bit faster, side to side. So I realize all that was in the way there. And now I'm going to slow down, put some pressure. Go ahead and finish back out. And of course, if I wasn't doing a video, I'd be going real fast here by myself. I'd be, you know, 4 minutes into it, I bet, and I'd be already done. I'm just taking my time. No need to rush anything. And let's give her a quick wipe.